Good morning. I was trying to do a live video, but I could not get it to work. I am going to work on that, and I am looking forward to perhaps starting some good morning yoga classes online for the Soul Oasis, and I hope that you will join me. And of course, these will be free. However, donations will be greatly accepted and appreciated as we all try to get through this time. So let us begin. I did a video on Monday and I talked about setting up a morning routine. And then I thought, as I was going through my morning routine, that perhaps I would share some of it with you. I just was outside, so I've come inside. It's actually really cool outside today and really nice. But I'm getting ready to do a little yoga practice, so I thought I would invite you to join me. Bear with me as I'm learning the technical issues of this, as I am doing this all on my own. I just got the kids settled. One's actually still sleeping, my high schooler, but my little one is now at the computer doing his homeschool, so I have a little free time. I'd like to invite you to take a moment, pause this video, go get something comfortable on, and find a space that makes you comfortable and happy. Are you back? I'm back. So I have my yoga mat laid out here. I had to change the direction a little bit. And I just want you to get into a comfortable seated position. Right now I am in Tadasana, or seated Tadasana, which is mountain pose, where I'm sitting on top of my legs. You can also cross your legs and just find yourself in a nice cross-legged position, or maybe if you're a little more advanced, you want to go to lotus pose. I find that sometimes a little bit much, and I tend to just stack my legs one on top of each other. But whatever position is comfortable for you, go ahead and get into that comfortable position. I'm a little back on my mat. You can sit more towards the front, wherever you want. I'm back a little bit, so I'm hoping that you can see me. Now that you're in your comfortable position, I'm going to get a starfish thrown into my lap. Take a deep breath. Don't mind distractions. Don't get frustrated. We all have a lot of people at home and doing different things. So I would like to just invite you to just let that distraction go. If your pet comes along, just roll with it. It's all good. So let us begin by taking a few deep breaths. We're going to breathe in through our nose and out through our mouths. You can close your eyes. I find that I do that a lot. And exhale. Really letting your body crumple down with that exhale, just pushing every last bit of air out. Inhale. Hold it for a moment and exhale. Noticing any tension in your body. Just really doing like a little mental scan as you do your breath. If you'd like to change it up now, you can do all of your breathing through your nose. Breathe in through your mouth. And as you breathe out, we're going to do an ujjayi breath where you take the tongue. I find this works really well. Take your tongue and touch it to the roof of your mouth as you close your mouth. And you will feel that air vibrate down your nose and make almost like an ocean wave sound. And I can tell you, I really miss the ocean right now. Inhale one more time, and on your next exhale, you're going to drop your chin to chest. And slowly as you inhale, let's roll your head over your shoulder, ear over the shoulder, and all the way to the back. Once you are looking all the way up, begin your exhale as you begin to descend your head down over your shoulder. I started going to the right. You can choose either side you want. And let's just get some movement in our necks today. Inhaling up and exhaling down. Noticing any tension in your shoulders, areas of stiffness. My neck is always stiff. And exhale. On the way down. Next exhale, or inhale rather, we are going to change directions. So, inhaling, rolling to the opposite direction. Nice and slow. As you do this, try to get your ear passing over your shoulder. Inhaling up. Exhaling down. Just take your time and do this a time or two more. And when you're ready and you feel that you have accomplished the goal that you want with your neck roll, just come back to center. Inhale, reach your arms up, making sure you don't hit something over to the side. Inhale your arms up, bring your palms together. Gently bring them down. As you go down, exhale. Take a breath here. As you exhale, let your arms go all the way down. And imagine that you're scooping energy up from the earth, bringing that energy like a giant rainbow, and we're pressing it into a ball over our heads. Bring that ball together nice and tight. Ooh, I can almost feel the energy right there. Exhale. Bring your hands back down. One more time. Inhale up, scooping all that beautiful energy up. Mother Gaia, on Earth Day, it's Earth Day. Exhale, bring your hands down. Go ahead and unravel your legs and bring them out in front of you. Take a deep breath in, tuck in the tummy. I'm always working on my tummy because I like cookies. Exhale, ooh, feel that stretch. Just bring your hands over your feet or maybe touch down, grab your toes. And just hold here for a moment. Maybe pull your feet back if you can reach them. If you can't, that's okay. Wherever you are, it's okay. The idea is just to get some breath, some oxygen and some movement in our bodies. So just reach out there and stretch as best as you can. Inhale up, all the way up. Maybe roll your shoulders down and back. You'll feel that tension right between your shoulder blades, and that's good. Hold that. Those muscles are really important for helping alleviate neck and upper back discomfort. As we strengthen those, you will feel better. A lot of us tend to get into this position where we just kind of slouch and our upper back muscles become weak. And then we don't know why we have pain. So go ahead and bring your arms just a little bit back behind your head. Exhale, coming down one more time. Ooh, feel that delicious stretch. Inhale, bring your legs over. Bring your hands to center once again. Let's go ahead and bring the right leg up and the left leg is down. I'm going to bring this leg over and I'm going to bring my left arm up. I'm going to bring it to the outside of my leg and I'm going to twist my body around, putting my arm directly behind my spine. My hand is flat on the ground behind me and now I'm going to, ooh, back crack. I'm going to reach up just a little bit, just getting a nice twist in there. Tuck in the tummy a little bit more, Inhale, exhale. On your exhale, see if you can't twist just a little bit more. On the next exhale, go ahead and unravel. Bring that leg out in front of you. Arms up. Bow down. Honor yourself. So delicious. Yeah, I'm a little bit of a verbal one. Let's go ahead and bring the other leg up. This would be my left leg now. I'm gonna bring my right arm to the air. Bring it to the side of me. Ooh, a little tight there. Don't worry about it. We all have our good days and bad days. Bring that left arm back as far as you can, hand flat down. Whatever is comfortable for you. Never strain. And just breathe. With each exhale, try to get a little bit more of a twist, wringing out the digestion system. If you've already eaten, this will help process your food, and it may make this a little bit more difficult. I have not had my breakfast yet. And when you're ready, exhale and unravel. Bringing the arms up once again and coming back down. Stretch out. So your legs are out in front of you. I adjusted the video just a little bit. And one more time, up and fold forward. You may notice that you're folding a little bit further. Maybe you're not. It's okay. Just feel good where you are. Next, we're gonna do some cat-cows. What you're gonna do, your feet are out in front of you, and you're just gonna swing your legs around to the side, swivel it around, and come up onto all fours. Okay, I am actually going to go to the side. So you can see what I'm doing. Ooh, look at this big puffy shirt. You know what, there's no judgment. Maybe you fill out that puffy shirt. Some days I do. And what we're gonna do is we're going to come flat, make ourselves a table. You're gonna have your knees right below your hips and your hands right below your shoulders. So you're going to inhale, dropping the belly all the way down. Tuck your toes under. I don't know if you can see my toes, but you're gonna put your toes like this, okay? And then when you go upwards, you're gonna have your feet like this. So it's gonna be tucked or flat. So your feet will be flat on the ground. Inhale. Roll the body up. Actually, that's an exhale. Pushing every last bit of air out. Inhale, filling the belly up, looking up, forward facing, tucking the toes, really push your tailbone back here so that you feel that stretch right along your spine. Exhale. It's okay. You know what? I'm doing inhale and exhale. Don't hold your breath while I do. Go ahead and breathe in between. Just try to breathe nice and slow. So exhale. Pushing all the air up. Inhale, tucking the toes under once again. I'm going to come back. This way, you're gonna stay the way you are. So we are on tabletop, and we're just gonna fold back. Now we are in Tadasana, seated Tadasana, which is mountain. And I want you to take a few deep breaths here. Open your hands, and you should feel some blood moving. Inhale your arms up. Exhale your arms down in front of you into a child's pose. You can spread your legs apart a little bit here, and you're going to come and place your forehead down on the mat. Take a few deep breaths here. And when you're ready, you're going to push back up into tabletop, tucking the toes down. I don't know if you can see them. I've got my feet inward. You want your feet right behind your knees. I'm doing this so you can see. So tuck your feet and press up into the all-famous downward dog. Oh my gosh, my dog does this in the cutest way. And just really give yourself a stretch.
I'm gonna turn here for a second. As you're stretching, go ahead and maybe walk your legs out a little bit. And bring yourself back around. Maybe lift the back leg up into the air, lowering the heel of the other leg. I have my right leg up. And then just bring it back down to meet. Feet are hip width apart here. And bring your other leg back up. And exhale, drop it down. Or hold it up there. I actually did that a little quicker. I'm trying not to keep you here too long. And exhale, drop that foot down. Take as long as you need here. Maybe lower your heels down a little bit, feeling that stretch in your calves, opening up your legs. Maybe pushing back through the arms and lifting your tailbone even higher into the air. Inhale one more time and exhale. Slowly begin to walk your feet to the front of the mat to meet your hands. You're in a forward fold now. And just hang there for a moment. Shake your head back and forth. Yes, no. Maybe fold your hands over your elbows. Just let yourself hang loosely here. Breathing. The biggest part of yoga is breath. Every breath you take brings blood or oxygen into your blood and helps revitalize your cells. Slowly start to lift up. I'm gonna step back on my mat here because this is the first time I've ever tried to do a videotaped yoga practice. You can stay at the front of your mat. I just came to the back so that you could see me. I may actually move my whole mat. Exhale, fold forward again, bringing your fingertips down to your feet. Hanging once again, taking about 3 deep breaths here and scoop all that energy from Gaia, Pachamama on Earth Day. Exhale, bring your hands to your chest. We're gonna go ahead and step the right leg forward, and you might be a little wobbly, and that's okay. And we're gonna turn our back foot to a slight 90 degree angle. And then not allowing our knee to go past our ankle, so we're creating almost a 90 degree angle right here. Inhale your arms up, and I have a feeling my head's been cut off, but that's okay. Exhale down. Just hold it here for a moment. You may be a little wobbly. Maybe you're just waking up. Maybe you've never done this before. Exhale, fold forward. Bring your hands down. Walk that foot up just a little bit, and just really get that nice stretch in your back leg. Go ahead and lift your head up, folding your head down to your knee. And exhale, put your hands down on the side. Bring that foot back to meet the other foot. Walk it out. This time, we're going to lower down. You can bring your knees down first and then come down and push up. Oh my gosh, that feels so amazing. Are you feeling it? I'm feeling it. Really waking up the body here. Maybe your arms are a little shaky. Go ahead and fold back into child's pose. Take a deep breath here. Honor your body. Come back to table. Tuck your toes under and press back into down dog. Lifting the left leg up, lowering the right heel. Take a breath and bring that right foot forward. Again, as you bring it forward, you're gonna swivel that hip, or hip, foot, and we're gonna lift our arms up into warrior one. Really feeling that nice stretch there. Bring your hands down to heart center. Bring your hands onto the inside. Walk that foot up so that knee is not jutted out over your foot. You want the knee over ankle. And you can just hold here. Your back heel on the right side, push it back a little bit and just feel that stretch. You should be feeling it like right in here, right around that hip and upper thigh. Just hold for a moment more. Go ahead and straighten that front leg, bringing your hands to either side of it to support yourself. Maybe you want to walk the back foot up. Just notice what feels comfortable and just fold your head over. You should feel it in your right calf. Don't forget to breathe. And then let's go ahead and walk our hands up a little bit. Bring your feet forward. Forward fold again. And inhale your arms up to the sky. I'm just stepping back. You stay at the front of your mat. And just breathe here for a moment. I didn't want to make this practice too complicated. I wanted to make it a little simple. I'm going to go ahead and come down now. You can come down to Tadasana or to Lotus. I just wanted to give you a little morning warm-up. You should already be feeling a lot better. Usually a yoga class will go on for an hour and we can go through many more poses. As this continues and goes on, we can expand. Maybe I'll do little clips and add on, but I just wanted to give you a little gentle wake-up practice today. I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope I didn't take up too much of your time, but I guarantee the time that you spent now will make all of the time in your day later be much more productive. You've got your cells going, your blood's flowing. Namaste.